Hey everybody, and welcome back to my coverage of the PogChamps 3 tournament. The first matchup of today, February 18th, 2021, is Michelle Khare versus Logic the Rapper. And Logic is definitely the favorite to win this matchup. He is higher rated. He won his matchup, unlike Michelle, in round one. So yeah, he's definitely the favorite. And we have a very quick game to start things off for today. So we'll see which one of the players prevailed, or somehow if they draw quickly. That's happens rarely at low levels of chess, but it is possible, so we'll see what happens. Michelle has the white pieces. She starts off with d4, Logic responds d5, and we have a London system from Michelle. Logic mirrors with bishop f5, and we have e3, Michelle continuing her London system setup, and Logic plays a6, and this move kind of doesn't really do anything, which is why I don't really like this move from Logic. He really should have just continued developing a move like knight c6 or e6. Both moves would have been better than a3, but we have a3. We have bishop d3 from Michelle, and Logic doesn't really want to trade this bishop here because it gives Michelle a nice center. Even though it doubles her pawns, the doubled pawns are very much worth it because you get this nice center control. So Logic backs up his bishop, which is very good, bishop g6. And we have c4 from Michelle, striking in the center. I really like this move from Michelle, so good job for her for finding it. We have knight c6, and here Michelle could have actually taken this pawn. So here you actually have to defend this pawn with another pawn, and usually in these double queen pawn games, if white pushes c4 and attacks the pawn on d5, you have to defend this pawn with another pawn, and you can't just leave it guarded with the queen or guard it with the knight in some cases, because after knight c6, Michelle could have actually punished the fact that this pawn was only defended by the queen with the sequence c cross d5, and after queen cross d5, first you have to defend this diagonal, so knight f3, and after any move from black, really, I just have a simple developing move, knight f6. Now we can play knight c3 and gain a tempo on this queen, and you're not going to want to waste that tempo as black. So you can basically win a tempo here as white, and so that's why knight c6 from Logic was a small inaccuracy, in my opinion, but we have knight c6, and Michelle does not go for the c takes d5 line. Instead, she plays knight c3. Just a normal developing move, totally fine as well. We have e6 from Logic and knight f3, knight f6, and castle. So Logic continuing development and Michelle getting castle. Both very good chess, or very good chess from both players so far. And here the game starts to get really spicy. First, we have bishop h5 from Logic. And this is pinning the knight to Michelle's queen. So she decides she doesn't like that and gets out of it with queen b3. So this queen coming to the b file to pressure this b pawn is very thematic in a lot of queen pawns openings. A lot of times you see black doing this, but here we have white doing it. So yeah, you're actually allowing yourself to get doubled pawns and rip open your king side. So that should definitely be something black should consider. And here Logic actually goes for it with bishop cross f3. And when you move your queen away from the defense of this knight, yes, you are unpinning it, but now you have to accept doubled pawns in front of your king, and your king is really exposed. You might get attacked later on. Here it's kind of weirdly almost okay, because you can drop this bishop back to g3, and the bishop sort of acts like a pawn and also has very nice control along this diagonal here, since the d-pawn is already advanced to d5. So it's kind of weirdly okay, though. I probably wouldn't go into it. I probably would just keep my pawn shield intact in front of my king. But here, Michelle doesn't actually... So yes, Logic did take this knight, and Michelle doesn't actually recapture this bishop. I think she was thinking, because she played queen takes b7. And here I think she was thinking, so I'm counterattacking your knight. Now you have two hanging pieces, so you can only save one of them. And whichever piece you don't save, I'm going to take on the next turn. However, this is a huge blunder, because here Logic can play knight a5. And what this does is it counterattacks the queen and saves the knight. So the queen cannot counterattack any other piece as of right now. So after white moves the queen, say queen takes c7. Here you actually have to be careful not to trade queens as Logic, because... if you do trade queens, then you allow bishop takes c7, and now your knight is hanging. So now you do have two pieces hanging, and after you save one of them, white will pick up the other one, and we're back to... Actually, you would first trade this bishop, because You wouldn't want to hang this bishop. But then you would take this, and white would have a very good game here. So you have to be careful not to trade queens here as a logic. So much better would be d-cross. Much better would be d-cross c4, and this is counterattacking this bishop. So lots of hanging pieces, but also opening up this bishop. So this bishop is diagonal, so it can safely retreat. It could have retreated to e4, but it wouldn't have been very good there. It would have just given white a very nice center. So after the bishop saves itself, bishop c2, black's bishop can safely retreat itself, and black will simply be up a piece here. So this is how logic could have taken advantage of Michelle's blunder with this queen takes b7. Instead, he does not play knight a5, but he does play the second best move, which is d takes c4, and basically the idea here is now the bishop defends the knight. So if you take the bishop, so you can't take the knight here, you have to take the bishop, which Michelle does with g takes f3. However, now the queen is actually trapped, and you also have to remember when this pawn opened up, you are counterattacking this bishop. So the queen actually has this one square c7 because it's guarded by the bishop. But the queen is trapped after knight a5. The only square for the queen is c7. And once the queen moves, now you have this free bishop on d3, which was hanging once again after the pawn captured on c4. So logic could have gone for this. However, he did not. Instead, actually, he did go for this. He did play knight a5. Sorry. But Michelle did not go for this. She didn't actually see this queen takes c7 move. She spent a lot of time on this move. She checked all the squares, every single square the queen can move to, except for this c7 square, I'm pretty sure. So she just didn't see that she could take this c7 pawn and save the queen. So instead, she took this rook on a8, queen takes a8, and obviously this is not as good as simply taking this pawn and losing the bishop, because now you're losing a full queen for a rook. So we have queen takes a8 by logic, and bishop e4 from Michelle. Probably bishop c2 would have been, but bishop e2 defending the f3 pawn would have been a little better, just to avoid this trade, because now logic's up in material. He wants to be trading down. So he can play knight takes e4. This also gets rid of Michelle's bishop pair. We have f takes e4 and bishop d6 from logic. And once again, you don't really want to be trading as here as Michelle. However, it's kind of a tough spot, because here if you play e5, then your bishop is just like shut out for the rest of the game. Your bishop is not going to be doing anything. All of your pawns are going to be on dark squares. So it's like, it's very hard whether you trade this bishop or not. But Michelle decides to hang on to the material, so not trading when she's down, which is a perfectly fine decision, and she plays e5. We have bishop e7 from logic and rook a b1 from Michelle, just trying to get her rooks activated. So I think she's planning to support this b4 pawn push, which right now is not possible because the bishop defends b4. We have queen f3 from logic, just getting his queen all up in Michelle's king's business. And this is a very active move from logic, very, very good move, taking advantage of white's open king. We have bishop g3, kind of sort of trying to defend from Michelle, and h5 from logic, not even castling, just going straight for the attack and using this rook on h8. Very technical, very good technical skills from logic. So congrats to him on that. And Michelle, here it's kind of already a lost position. I mean, you can try h4 to stop, but then there will be g5, and it's falling apart for Michelle. There's not a lot you can do to defend. But she continues with her plan anyway with b4, and logic just keeps pushing that h pawn. He just plays h4, now attacking this bishop, and now even the even bigger threat rather than just taking this bishop is h3, and there will be checkmate on g2. So here you actually have to play a move like rook fe1, and you have to lose the bishop basically, and but this position is already very, very losing for white. So there's really nothing white can do here. Michelle played bishop f4, so saving her bishop. By the way, logic did not even take time to save his knight. He just kept going on with his attack. So great job to him on that. That was like recognizing that saving this knight was not important when there's a very tasty king on g1. So good job to him for that. We have h3 from Logic, and there's nothing Michelle can do. So she plays b takes a5, maybe hoping for some rook b8 stuff, but even if she got this somehow and picked up this rook, it still wouldn't stop this checkmate. So Logic played queen g2, and this is checkmate. So first game goes to Logic. We'll see if Michelle can bring it back with the second game and take this match to an Armageddon. I don't think I have anything else to say about this game or this match, so thank you for watching. Check out my PogChamps 3 playlist up there, and the next game of this match will be on the left side of the screen over there, so check those out, and thank you for watching. I love you all, and I'll see you next time.